أهلاً وسهلاً. This time we're going to talk about a verb which is very important in Arabic grammar. It's the verb kana. Kana is the verb to be. You remember that verbs are in Arabic are always quoted in third masculine past form. So the word kana means he was. So kana is a weak verb, only two consonants. Kaf, Noon, and the third consonant is hidden behind the Aleph. Kana in the present is Yakunu. Yakunu, so the real root of this verb is Kaf, Waw, Noon. There are other verbs which follow the same rules of Kana and which are called Kana wa Akhawatuha. Akhawat is the plural of ukht, sister. So, Kana and her sisters. Here are two examples of akhawat Kana, which are Sara, Sara yasiru, and Asbaha, Asbaha yusbihu. Both mean the same thing, to become. A sentence beginning with the verb Kana is considered a verbal sentence, jumla fi'liya. The lesson was boring. Remember that khabar kana is always in the accusative case. Don't ask why. This is our sentence without vowels. So kana ad-darsu, and you have to know the word mumil, which is boring, and you understand that it is in the accusative because of the alif. Even in vowel-less spoken Arabic, this case after the khabar kana has to be pronounced. So kana dars mumillan. Now we have another example, which is kanat is-sayaratu mukassaratan. Kanat is-sayaratu mukassaratan. Sayara is car, and mukassar is an adjective which means broken, which means destroyed. So the car was destroyed. You remember that in the third feminine form, fa'alat, katabat, even kanat, there is a sukun here. But here we have to tie with the article, which takes the wasla, and then you put a kasra in order to say kanatis sayaratu mukassaratan. So this is the ism kana, which is in the nominative case, is the subject of kana, and this is the khabar kana, which has to go in accusative. So kanat sayara mukassara, the car was completely destroyed. Mukassar is stronger than maksur. Kassara, kassara is to break. Kassara is to destroy. Once again we have Kana Ahmadu Mut'aban. Kana Ahmadu Mut'aban. Ahmad is a proper name. Ahmad is the ism Kana. And Mut'ab is tired. So Ahmad was tired. The adjective is Mut'ab or Mut'abun, but as khabar Kana it has to be in the accusative. So Kana Ahmadu Mut'aban. You can also say kan Ahmad mut'aban. In this case you'll have to pronounce the accusative an, which you are helped in seeing the alif. Well, I'm sure now you're wondering how to say he was not. He was not. You have two possibilities. The simplest one is to use the negation ma. Ma kana. He was not. Lam followed by the elisive mode, which ends in sukun. So, kana yakunu yakun. Lam yakun. You will find this first possibility easier, of course. But this form is considered more elegant. It's lighter than ma kana. As you remember, yakun is a present form, which normally is yakunu, yakunu with waw. So in the ISF mode, you have to put a sukun instead of the dhamma, But before sukun, you cannot have a long vowel, so the waw goes away. Lam. Yakun. He was not. You want to say, I was not married. And it's a woman, a girl, who is speaking. So, you can say, Ma kuntu mutazawijatan. Mutazawijatan, mutazawijun is married, masculine. Mutazawija in feminine. Ma kuntu mutazawijatan, or Lam akun mutazawijatan. Lam akun mutazawijatan. This is more frequent. Both mean I was not married. Without vowels. Ma kunt mutazawija. Lam akun mutazawija. Further example. Lam yakun zanbaka. Lam yakun zanbaka. It was not your fault. It was not your fault. I am speaking to a man. If I'm speaking to a woman, I would say Lam yakun zanbaki. And pay attention with this word. This can be two words. Zanb, zanb with sukun is fault. Zanab is tail. So if you say Lam yakun zanabaka, you mean it was not your tail, which doesn't mean anything. This is a sentence which could say a man whose heart is broken. أعطيتكِ كل شيء ولم يكن هذا كافياً. أعطيتُ, the verb is أعطى, يعطي, to give. أعطيتكِ, I gave to you كل شيء, everything, all I could. ولم يكن, و can have also the meaning of but. لم يكن هذا, but this was not sufficient. That was not enough. أعطيتك كل شيء ولم يكن هذا كافيا. أعطيتك. You have to pronounce كل شيء. كل شيء. أعطيتك كل شيء ولم يكن هذا كافيا. Let's use it now in the future. So I wrote, ستكون هذه السنة صعبة جدا. Sana is year, demonstrative, and صعب, صعبٌ is means difficult. جدًا is very. So ستكون هذه السنة صعبة جدا. هذه السنة is the اسم كان and is in a nominative. صعبة is the خبر كان. That's why it goes in accusative. This year will be very difficult. ستكون هذه السنة صعبة جدا. Some people claim that the scene now is no more used and that you can say تكون هذه السنة صعبة جدا. Without vowels, تكون هذه السنة صعبة جدا. And it has the same meaning. This year will be very difficult. Let's try to use it in the negative for the future. You know that future has to be negated, but لن and منصوب. So, أنا أكون, لن أكون, I won't be, لن أكون هنا الأسبوع القادم. أسبوع is week, قادم next. So, I won't be here next week. This sentence is for me, because I take some days of holidays for Christmas. لن أكون هنا الأسبوع القادم. You remember that in the present tense, we do not use the verb to be, so we just use a nominal sentence. المعلم متعب. But you may use يكون, especially if preceded by ربما, which means maybe or perhaps, to introduce a guess you have. ربما يكون المعلم متعبا قليلا. The teacher could be a little tired. The same nuance is expressed by kad instead of robbama. Kad yakunu, it might be, it may be. So kad yakunu al-muallimu mutaban qalilan. Without final vowels, you may hear kad yakun al-muallim mutaban qalilan. Here you have to respect the accusative. The teacher might be a little tired. Another example with قد يكون أفضل أن تسافر إلى المغرب. أفضل means preferable or better. So here I'm saying قد يكون أفضل, it could be better, it could be the best way, the best thing that you go to Morocco. قد يكون أفضل أن تسافر إلى المغرب. قد يكون أفضل أن تسافر إلى المغرب. Well, this is an example which stay for an old person of my age. كان يقرأ الجريدة. So قرأ, يقرأ is to read, is the newspaper, جريدة. Using كان followed by the present, you have our imperfect. He was reading, or he used to read. So كان يقرأ الجريدة. He used to read the newspaper, or he was reading the newspaper. Without final vowels, you can hear كان يقرأ الجريدة. Here we have an example with the subject أبي, أب, father. أبي is my father. So كان أبي يشتغل في المقهى. My father was working or used to work in the cafeteria. Without final vowels, you may hear كان أبي يشتغل في المقهى. Finally, and then it's finished, you can use كان with a past verb, but in most cases you have to insert قد. كان قد كتب قصة. He had written a story. It's a past perfect. In first person, you would say كنت قد كتبت قصة. Without final vowels, you may hear كان قد كتب قصة. شكرا. Thank you. You will find some difficulties, but don't worry. You'll see that soon you'll get it. I wish you a great day and see you soon.